हेलो एवरीवन, आवर टुडेज टॉपिक इज ऑप्टिक नर्व। सो ऑप्टिक नर्व इन लैटिन इट इज ऑल्सो टू बी कॉल्ड एज नर्वस ऑप्टिकस। इन लैटिन इट इज ऑल्सो टू बी कॉल्ड एज नर्वस ऑप्टिकस। इंट्रोडक्शन। दिस ऑप्टिक नर्व इट इज अ नर्व ऑफ साइट और विजन। इट इज अ सेकेंड क्रैनियल नर्व एंड दिस सेंसरी इन नेचर और इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड अ सेंसरी नर्व। इट इज प्योरली सेंसरी नर्व। सो इट इज अ नर्व ऑफ साइट और विजन एंड इट इज अ सेकेंड क्रैनियल नर्व एंड इट इज अ प्योरली सेंसरी नर्व रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द विजन। नाउ व्हाट आर द अदर क्रैनियल नर्व्स? द क्रैनियल नर्व्स दे आर 12 पेयर। देर आर 12 पेयर ऑफ द क्रैनियल नर्व। फर्स्ट इज द ऑल्फैक्टरी, सेकेंड इज द ऑप्टिक विच इज अवर टूडेज टॉपिक, थर्ड इज द ऑक्यूलोमोटर, फोर्थ इज द ट्रॉक्लियर, फिफ्थ इज द ट्राइजेमिनल, सिक्स इज द एब्डुसेंट, सेवेंथ इज द फेशियल, एट इज द ऑडिटरी और वेस्टिबुलो कॉक्लियर, नाइन्थ इज द ग्लोसो फारेंजियल नर्व, टेंथ इज द वैगस नर्व, इलेवेंथ इज द स्पाइनल एसेसरी और एसेसरी नर्व and 12th is the hypoglossal nerve. So these are the 12 pair of cranial nerves. Now how this optic nerve gets originated or how it is made up of? This optic nerve, it is made up of by the axons in the ganglionic layer of retina. As we had know, the retina that lies in the posterior part of the eyeball. So there are different layers of retina. There are about 10 layers of the retina which lies from outside to inside. So the 8th layer from outside to inside is the ganglionic layer. So how it is made up of? It is made up of by the axons in the ganglionic layer of retina which emerges from the eyeball from its posterior pole or the from behind. So this optic nerve, it is nothing but made up from the axons. So it is a total all the different axons which lies in the ganglionic layer of the retina which emerges from the posterior pole of the eyeball. Now we will see the course of optic nerve. So as we had seen, the optic nerve that arises from the layer of the ganglionic cells, axons of the ganglionic layer of retina. So it arises from the retina. From the 8th layer of the retina. So from the posterior pole, as I had told you, it arises from the posterior pole. So from the posterior pole of the eyeball, so these are the two eyeballs, right and left eyeballs. From the posterior pole of the eyeball, they runs or they passes backward and medially. So like this, they passes backward and medially towards the middle eye. Suppose this is our center. This is our center. So it passes like this. Backward and medially through the orbit. So it first passes backward and medially through the orbit. The cavity in which the eyeball lies is called as orbit. So it passes first backward and medially through the orbit, then through the optic canal. This optic canal, it is a canal which lies in the sphenoid bone. The bone, this is the bone of this face and brain or face and skull. So the it passes through optic canal, this optic canal which lies in the sphenoid bone, which is a bone of skull, and finally through the cranial cavity. So then here, after passing from the optic canal, it enters in the cranial cavity. So and finally through the cranial cavity and then end by joining the nerve of opposite side to form the optic chiasma. So this nerve arises from the posterior medial aspect of the eyeball and runs on the posterior medial aspect of the eyeball in the orbit. Then it runs to the optic canal. Optic canal, it is a gap in the sphenoid bone. The sphenoid bone is situated on the base of the brain. Then after that, they finally through the cranial cavity. Then it enters in the cranial cavity. After optic canal, after passing from the optic canal, it enters in the cranial cavity proper and then ends by joining. So here it enters in the cranial cavity and ends by joining with the opposite side to form the optic chiasma. See, here the this is the left one optic nerve and this is the right one optic nerve. Both are meeting here and the meeting point is called as optic chiasma. And here it gets ends. And then after that there is a passes of this visual pathway. So this is about the course and termination of the optic nerve. So arise from the posterior pole of the eyeball, from the retinal layer, runs backward and medially through the orbit, then through the optic canal and finally through the cranial cavity, and then in the and end by joining the nerve of opposite side to form the optic chiasma. Then we will see the length. The length of the optic nerve is 40 millimeter or 4 centimeter. It is to be 40 millimeter or 4 centimeter, in which the 25 mm means 2.5 centimeter lies in the orbit. I had told you the cavity in which the eyeball are situated are called as orbit. So in the orbit there is a 25 mm or the 2.5 centimeter part of the optic nerve lies in the orbit, while as 5 mm lies in the optic canal. As I had told you, he passes first through the orbit, then through the orbit canal. So while passing through the orbit canal, it is having length of only 5 mm or 0.5 centimeter, and then finally it passes through the cranial cavity. So the final of the part of the cranial cavity that lies in the cranium is 10 mm or 1 centimeter. Now we will see the structure of optic nerve, the anatomical structure of optic nerve. The optic nerve, it is, they are having 1.2 million myelinated nerve fiber. So it is having 1.2 million myelinated nerve fiber in each optic nerve. So in each optic nerve, there are about 1.2 million myelinated nerve fibers. Only 53% crosses the optic chiasma. So only 53% will cross the optic chiasma. Rest will not cross the optic chiasma. So it is about having 1.2 million myelinated nerve fibers in each optic nerve. Second, it is not a nerve, but it is a tract, because from the optic chiasma, the nerve becomes the optic tract. So it is not a nerve, but it is a tract. So it is also called as optic tract. It is not lined by the neuro-level sheath, but it is lined by the oligodendrocytes. That's why it is to be called as the part of central nervous system. That's why it is called as part of a central nervous system, because it is lined by the oligodendrocyte, not by the neural nervous system or the Schwann cells, which are lining the peripheral in the peripheral nervous system. So it is lined by the oligodendrocyte. That's why it is a part of central nervous system. So this is about the structure of the optic nerve. Now we will see the visual pathway, how the visual pathway travels. So first, the visual pathway travels through the retina. As I had told you, the nerve forms nerve that made up of from the posterior pole of the eyeball, from the eighth layer of the retina as a ganglionic layer, axons of the ganglionic layer of the retina. From the retina, the nerve goes posteriorly, posteromedially. Then it is to be called as optic nerve proper. Here it is to be called as optic nerve proper, where it travels in the optic canal, then the cranial cavity. First travels in the orbit, then in the optic canal, and then in the cranial cavity. So this, after that, the nerve of opposite side, in which there the nasal part that crosses, the temporal part that runs downward straight, but the nasal component that crosses with each other, and here it is called as optic chiasma. So it travels through the retina, then the optic nerve proper, and here optic chiasma, here the nerve gets end, and then the tract gland begins. Now from the optic chiasma, this is a tract. So this is called as optic tract. From this optic chiasma, it goes to the lateral geniculate body. So this is the lateral geniculate body on the either side. This lateral geniculate body, it is a part of subthalamus, and subthalamus is a part of diencephalon. Hamne dekh chuke hain ki what is diencephalon. Diencephalon, it is a part of the forebrain. The deeper part of the forebrain is called a diencephalon. either thalamus, subthalamus, metathalamus, epithalamus. They are the different parts which lies in the diencephalon. So this lateral geniculate body, it is a part of the subthalamus, and from the lateral geniculate body, this optic radiation travels and this goes to the visual area of the cerebral cortex. So these are the optic radiations. These are the optic radiations, and this optic radiation goes to the visual area of the cerebral cortex, which is like on the occipital lobe, and the image is formed. So this is whole the optic pathway or the visual pathway. How we get able to see the structures? So this light travels like this, and the image is formed on the occipital area or the visual area, which is in the occipital pole of the brain. Now we will see the clinical or applied anatomy. Clinical or applied anatomy. First, the optic neuritis. So inflammation, as we know, inflammation is to be called as itis. So inflammation of optic nerve is called as optic neuritis. So what happens in the optic neuritis cases? The patient is having pain in and behind the eye. If the patient is complaining pain in and behind the eye, so it may be case of optic neuritis. So inflammation of optic nerve. Now ophthalmoscopy or fundoscopy. What is ophthalmoscopy or fundoscopy? It is an examination of the eye with the help of an instrument called as ophthalmoscope or fundoscope. So it is to be called as examination of the eye with the help of ophthalmoscope or fundoscope. That is to be called as ophthalmoscopy. Now the third one, we had seen it is not lined by the neural level sheath. Because of this, that it is not lined by the neural level sheath, it is having no power of regeneration. Once the optic nerve is get damaged, it is not regenerated. So there may be a permanent blindness due to the damage of optic nerve. So because it is not lined by the neural level sheath, that's why there is no power of regeneration. Now the atrophy, the next applied part of clinical part is the atrophy of optic nerve. This atrophy or shrinking of the optic nerve, it is to be seen in many diseases. It may be primary or secondary. Either it originates, the cause may be there only, or it may be cause may be the secondary one. Means not in the nerve proper, but it is to be secondary one. So the atrophy of optic nerve. So these are the very important clinical or applied aspect of the optic nerve. Thank you. Thank you very much.